guys, so this video is all about GMDSS, sending of a distress message and cancellation of false distress alerts. So this equipment which you can see here, this is called as VHF, as you can see here, number one VHF telephone. So this is basically called as very high frequency equipment, and the use of this equipment is to send distress message or for communication purposes. So to send a distress message, what you have to do is, here you can see a distress button, the red color. Now it has a hinge, which is there basically to prevent accidental pressing of this button. That's why this plastic cover is given. There are two types of distress message. One is undesignated and the another is designated. So to send an undesignated distress message, you have to just lift this hinge cover and you have to press the distress button for at least 4 seconds. So the 4 seconds time duration which is there for pressing the distress button is basically, if you accidentally press the distress button and if you want to cancel immediately and you don't want to let it transmit, so you have the option of 4 seconds. So you can, before 4 seconds, if you release the button, then the distress alert will not be transmitted. That is why the 4 second duration is given for activating the distress alert. If the button is pressed beyond 4 seconds, it will be transmitted. You press it for 4 seconds, you will get an intermittent sound, which means that the sound will be interrupted. And after 4 seconds, when the distress message, distress alert is activated, you will get a continuous beep of sound, which is continuous, not interrupted. So, which gives an indication that your message is transmitted. So this is how you will send undesignated distress message when you don't have time to update the nature of distress. The second way is to send a designated distress message. For that, you need to go to menu, and after menu, you have to go to third option here, editing a distress message, then click enter. After going into this section, here you can see nature. So if I click on enter, I can select whatever distress nature, whatever I'm facing. Let's say it's abandoned ship or piracy attack, man overboard, fire, flooding, collision, grounding, listing, sinking, or your vessel is disabled. So these are all the options in the nature. Then second is the position. Now this position is basically updated automatically by the GPS feed, but if it's not updated, there is an option to update manually. Also the UTC time. So once you have selected this, all the parameters, after selecting, you can press this distress button same for at least 4 seconds, then your message will be transmitted as a designated distress message, where you have time to update your distress details. So that was about sending of a distress message. So if somebody has acknowledged your DSC alert, then the sound will go louder. So at that time, as soon as somebody has acknowledged your alert, this DSC distress alert, the next thing which you have to do is you have to pick up the radio telephone and start speaking. Mayday, ship's name, MMSI number, call sign, position, nature of distress, and the request for the rescue. So this is all you have to speak in the radio telephone, because if somebody has received your distress DSC alert, after receiving, he will switch to radio telephone mode, and he switches on radio telephone mode. So that's why you have to speak, so that he can understand what is the exact problem you are facing. Now, the second thing about this VHF is about the cancellation of a false DSC alert. So by chance, if you have transmitted a false DSC alert, what you have to do is you have to immediately press the off button. You have to switch off this equipment. Now here you can see that I've turned off you can see here, you have to press dim and power button both together, so it will be turned off. After turning off the equipment, what happens is the transmitting of the DSC alert will stop, and after that you can turn on again. After turning on, you go to radio telephone mode, and it's already in radio telephone mode, so you have to pick up the handset and you have to speak. What you have to speak is all stations, all stations, all stations. Then this is ship's name and call sign and MMSI number, position, and cancel my false distress alert, and date and time of whatever the distress alert which was being transmitted. This is what things you have to speak so that the nearby vessels, and if the coast station is nearby for VHF, they will understand that you have transmitted unintentionally and it's a false distress alert, and that's why please cancel my alert. So this is how you have to cancel the VHF DSC distress alert. So that was about VHF equipment.